welcome back to my channel. Please excuse my crazy hair right now, I've just finished doing a workout. However, I'm going to jump in the shower now and I'm going to make the pinch and arm tiramisu, so let's get into it. Okay, so I've got all the ingredients laid out here. So I've got decaf coffee that I'm going to use to make the espresso, the cocoa powder, the sponge fingers, the vanilla bean paste, the ricotta, and then I've got some sweetener, and then I've got all the stuff that I need. So I've got the ramekins, the bowl, I've got a measuring jug, sieve, the various different quantities that I'm gonna need, and then obviously my scales and the recipe. So let's get right into it. Right, okay, what we're gonna start off by doing is putting the kettle on, because we really wanna be making this espresso, because it needs to brew for 4 minutes. So I'm using decaf because it's gonna be a dessert and I don't really wanna be kept up at night. So I don't have an espresso maker or anything like that, so I'm just going to use double the amount of coffee that you would in just a standard coffee in a cafetiere. And then I'm going to put... You done? Yeah. Brilliant. I thought you were gonna go. Right. So I'm gonna pour a little bit of water in the bottom. I'm gonna stir it. And let that sit for about 30 seconds before we put the rest of the water in. Now we're gonna pour the rest of the water in. And it says you need about 100 ml of espresso. So I'm just gonna pop the lid on and then pop the timer on for 4 minutes and then put that to one side. So while that's brewing, we're gonna get the bowl and ricotta. So we're going to put 150 grams of ricotta into the bowl. Here's a spoon. Check that out. So 150. Grams. Da, da, da. Nearly there. There or thereabouts. There we go. I'll leave it in there. I'll wipe my finger. And then we're going to put in 2 teaspoons of granulated sweetener, 1, 2, and we're also going to put in 2 teaspoons of vanilla bean paste. I've never actually used this before, but it looks a bit liquidy, so I'm going to give it a little stir. Oh no, it's definitely the consistency, it's just supposed to be liquid. And then 2 teaspoons of this.
One. Two. Oh, that smells amazing. And then we're just gonna stir this up. It doesn't say whisk or anything like that, it just says mix, so. I don't really know how smooth ricotta can get. Do you like tiramisu? Why? Have you never had one? Oh, it's like my favourite dessert. Should have done one of them TV chef moments. Here's one that I prepared earlier, but just a lot of mixing. Gonna press the plunger. The key is on a cafetiere not to press it all the way to the bottom because then it just pushes all the grain up through. So just leave it a little bit from the bottom. It says you need 100 mil of an espresso. So let's hope that I've made 100 mil. There we go. Perfect. So put that to the side and I'll let that cool for a bit. That should be about right. Consistency. So, that to one side. Take the four ramekins. It says that they need to be about 125 mil big. So I just tested that. There's two different types, but they're both 125 mil. And get the sponge fingers. Oh, these look so good. And it says to break them into three parts. And just put them in the bottom of each ramekin. One in each one. Oh, that's more than three. A couple of teaspoons of espresso in each. That coffee smells so good. You know what, I'm just going to use a little bit for that because that does not look like a lot at all. I'm going rogue. Spilling it everywhere. Not like me. I need a spoon. Oh yeah, there we go. It's really sick. Oh, these are going to be so good. I am so excited. This is what it looks like after I've done that. And then, all you're going to do is cover with a layer of ricotta mix. Each one. So once you've covered it with a layer of the ricotta mix, it then tells you to get one more sponge finger per layer to break it up and put it on each one. It says in three pieces again, but really it's just to layer it up. Finding that four fits these ramekins best, I suppose it's whatever you're using. Say that and then I do three for each one. And then it just says to cover with another layer of the coffee. And then the ricotta mix again. So I'm just gonna sprinkle a bit of the coffee on. like a Kahlua or a Bailey's in, I bet that would be lovely. But we're going for the low-cal. Right, and then this is what they're looking like now. Covered in with the ricotta, and then it's just sprinkle over the cocoa powder. So it says you're gonna wanna use 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder in a sieve. And just to sieve it over the top of tiramisus. Oh, I am excited for these. Other than making a mess. And there we have it. Our low calorie tiramisus. I'll show them you in a sec. But they're only 108 calories per tiramisu. And I think that I want to eat them all. So here they are. I just need to chill them now in the fridge for 10 minutes, he says. And clean up this mess. Right, okay, so I've got a stretch and tone class now with the pole dancers, and honestly I cannot wait to get back to pole dancing. It's one of the main things that I'm missing most. I'm not really in workout gear or anything, but it's more like keeping us all supple ready for when we get back, so I'll time lapse a bit of that in now. Look at them bad boys. It's my size of my hand. Exciting. Kieran, are you enjoying your bone? So it's 10 to 9 now, and I think I'm just going to get ready for bed and watch a bit of Money Heist in bed. I am absolutely obsessed with Money Heist at the moment, so I'm going to catch up on a bit of that. But that's it for today, guys. So thank you all for watching, and I'll catch you in my next vlog.